Hello, Milwaukee. I'm Joni Madden, and I'm sharing the wonderful Zoom video with you, with all my cohorts in the fantastic Cherish the Ladies, if I can say so myself. We are so missing heading off to your festival this year. Every musician just loves to do the Milwaukee Irish Festival, and I believe this was going to be our 30th anniversary since the first time we performed there. So, without any further ado, let's get some music happening. We're going to give you a live track. Have a listen to this. See you in a few seconds. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed that couple of tunes there with fantastic dancers. Well, I'm Joni Madden, and I am from Yonkers, New York. I was born in the Bronx, and I've had such great memories of Milwaukee, some of the greatest memories of my life, and some of the greatest friendships I've met in the music business at that festival. But we were looking forward to bringing a beautiful singer with us this year, Kate Purcell, all the way from County Clare. But she's been to the Milwaukee Festival before, haven't you, Kate?
I have indeed, yeah, many years ago. I went there a couple of times as a solo act on the smaller stages, and I remember seeing Cherish the Ladies there and looking up at them saying, oh my God, someday, someday. And I was so looking forward to that someday being this year, but it'll be next year, hopefully. And it would be a great thrill, and totally looking forward to it. So roll on next year when it all happens again.
Nollick Casey is on the fiddle, and Nollick's all the way from Bantry and County, or no, Bandon and County Cork. I better get that right, Nollick?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm totally looking forward as well to playing with Cherish the Ladies in Milwaukee. I haven't played with Cherish there before, but I have played there three or four times with, I played there with my husband, Artie McLinn, as a duo. I also played in Milwaukee in the late 90s with a group I used to play with called Coot Finn. And I also played there with a quartet that we had called the Heartstring Quartet, with my sister Marnie Kohasig on harp and her husband Chris Newman on guitar, and my husband Artie McLinn.
There you go. KT, you've done many of many Milwaukee festivals. Where are you coming from?
I'm coming from Glasgow, Joni. I'm Kathleen Boyle, or KT Boyle, as I'm affectionately known in the band. And I come from Glasgow and play the piano with Cherish the Ladies. And this would have been my fourth time performing at the Milwaukee Festival. And I've had some fantastic memories there. In my earlier days and my fitter days of Cherish the Ladies, one of them involved getting up very early in the morning for a 5K with the fiddle player at the time, Gráinne Murphy. And I wasn't taking it too seriously, but Gráinne was, and she ended up coming in third in the 5 kilometre race. We left all the girls at the bar at 7 in the morning and we went out for the 5K.
Well, that's the one thing about Milwaukee. It's, you know, some of the greatest musicians on the planet. We're all together in one place, and everybody knows that the crack is going to be mighty. And really, I remember I met Mary Black there for the first time, and I remember meeting Daydan in there, and meeting, you know, who else do you remember meeting, KT or Coogie or Morella?
Loads of folks.
Oh, all
loads of musicians. Yeah, all the greats. Yeah. I remember listening to Liz Carroll actually, and she was playing a beautiful set at the festival, and in fact she had
Field in America
on guitar with her guesting, so it was lovely to listen to their set together.
And Morella, where are you, Morella?
Hi, Johnny. I'm in Connemara, County Galway, and I play the accordion with Cherish the Ladies, and I was so looking forward to Milwaukee this year. I've had nothing but great memories from there and great old fun. I think the first year I did was 2005. I think your dad was there that year. That was my first time there. And I loved it. I couldn't get over the massive crowds. We always play at the on the Aer Lingus stage. And to look out, I don't know, there could be 10,000 people out there or more, you know.
More.
So, I was looking forward to that. I'm sure more this year. But hopefully now next year we'll be there. So I'll be looking forward to it.
And Mary Coogan?
Hi, everybody. I'm here in Yonkers, New York, just across the town from Joni. And can't believe that it's 30 years since our first visit to Milwaukee. And it was always a dream come true. We were so excited the first year we went. And every year, it's been just as exciting since then, and just met so many great friends. And the atmosphere is beyond compare there. So really looking forward to next year.
I remember when I used to get the phone call from Chuck or Ed Ward, and they would tell us that they were inviting us. So I think we did 13 years in a row. We were back to Milwaukee, and we didn't matter. You'd swear to God it was Christmas morning. We were jumping around like a bunch of lunatics, so excited. You know, of all the wonderful times that we had there, it was just always magical. And, you know, not only again, you know, the Milwaukee people, they have it right, you know, starting with the wards and now Barry has taken over. And what you know, again, they encompass not just the festival, but it's a big learning thing. I've taught many, many weeks there. Over at the university there, and we've taught master classes and have people come to me there and who are now teachers themselves, which is amazing to see. And not only do they do, you know, the rock stage, but, you know, the whole historical from the Clancy brothers, you know, the Tommy Makems, the schooner fairs that were there every year, but also had the cultural tent going on with some of the finest traditional musicians on the planet, and as well as the dancing tent and of course the main stages where your big acts would perform. But people came from all over from everywhere. And that's what makes that festival a melting pot of people from all over who come together, who love Irish music. But also in addition to the fantastic job they do with all the various festival tents that they have, they always brought the families together. And we have some of our best memories, Mary.
Yes, we do.
In
2005, I believe, my dad and your dad and Mike Rafferty and Liam Clancy and Tommy Makem and Rory, I think we're all a part of the family gathering there, and it was really a thrill to have them all together.
They look outside the box and they put us together, and I have these beautiful videos of those moments with our dads, which, you know, again, it's not like today when everybody had a phone in their pocket. And we watching that video, actually, that just came up, that we just recently found, it inspired us to think about when we just had the Father's Day celebration. We decided to incorporate those tracks, and we recorded a song written by our great friend, the wonderful, wonderful Phil Coulter from Derry, one of the best songwriters there is ever. The man's a genius, and he gave us permission to record the song. Kate, you did a beautiful job on it.
Thank you very much. It was a joy to sing anyway, because a song like that, you know, it basically sings itself, because the words are so poignant and, you know, they mean so much to everybody, and it paints its own picture of a story that everybody knows, and the old man and missing somebody very special in your life, your father or your father figure. And it was just a very special song to sing, to be honest.
So here we go. Why don't we listen to the old man, Phil Coulter's beautiful song, with our own twist on it.
The tears of all shed now, we've said our last goodbyes. His soul's been blessed, he's laid to rest, but it's now I feel alone. He was more than just a father, a teacher, my best friend. He can still be heard, tunes we share when we play them on our own. And I never will forget him, for he made me what I am. Though he may be gone, memories linger on. And I miss him, child, he'd take me walking by mountain, field, and stream. He showed me things not known to kings, and secrets between him and me, like the colors of a pheasant as he rises in. How to fish and make a wish You'd live forever. He seemed so big and strong, but the minutes fly and the years roll by for a father and a son. And suddenly, when it happened, there was so much left unsaid. No second chance. Tell him thanks for everything he had done. I never will forget him. He made me what I am. Though he may be gone, memories linger on. And I miss him.
So there you go, folks. The wonderful Old Man, sung by Kate Purcell there. Well, listen, you know, speaking of my father, we're going to play two tunes from our latest album, Heart of the Home. And these are two tunes that I composed called The Portumna Workhouse and The Hurling Boys of Portumna, a set of reels that we recorded back in Portumna in County Galway when we were there on tour last year. So hope you enjoy these couple of tunes, folks. Here they go. Thank you. Well, I know how much we are missing the festival, but a dear friend of ours that was going to make his debut at Milwaukee Irish Festival was also the great Nathan Carter. And Nathan is just a legend in Ireland and in England and Scotland. And we asked him to join us on our title track of Heart of the Home. And it's a beautiful song written by the one and only Andy M. Stewart, who also performed with Silly Wizard at the festival in the past. But Andy wrote this song and it touched our souls, and we invited Nathan Carter to come in and sing it with us, and it wound up being the title track of the album. So folks, Nathan's missing it. We're missing it. I hope you enjoy this song, Heart of the Home.
He still smiles when he recalls how the gold ring fit her finger, and they made that moment linger, that in memory be strong. They had made a brand new start, found a whole new way of living. Two voices joined together, singing old sad songs. And when the hard times come around, may you see them through together. Let there be love and laughter in the heart of your home. And in life's darkest days, while you sail through stormy waters, let there be love and laughter in the heart of your home. Leaving there was always hard, leaving her was never easy. With those memories to tease you, summer nights seemed winters long. But in his heart there was a song, and the only sound worth hearing. Two voices joined together, singing old sad songs. When the hard times come around, may you see them through together. Let there be love and laughter in the heart of your home. And in life's darkest days, while you sail through stormy waters, let there be love and laughter in the heart of your home. Still smiles when he recalls how they counted little fingers, and their gratitude still lingers that the boy was born so strong. They had made a brand new life, found a whole new way of living. Three voices joined together, singing old sad songs. When the hard times come around, may you see them through together. Let there be love and laughter in the heart of your home. And in life's darkest days, while you sail through stormy waters, let there be love and laughter in the heart of your home. Let there be love and laughter in the heart of your home.
So there you go, Nathan Carter joining us with Heart of the Home. And we recorded that in Carlingford. Do you remember that day, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, it was great.
In Lily Flanagan's. Well, listen, folks, we're going to do one more for you now. Our sand is running out of the hourglass. But we just want to say a big thank you to all the volunteers in Milwaukee. You know, since the first time we went, we were blown away by the hospitality and how everything ran like a precision time clock. It was just unbelievable. All the people that pick us up and drop us off. and, you know, take care of all the hospitality behind the stage, the food and the drinks, and the incredible stage hands that we have, stage managers, our Jim O'Keefe and Tall Paul and all the O'Keefe brothers. And we've just great, great memories, lifelong of friendships that we've built up down through the years of making our way to Milwaukee. And let me tell you, 2021, we're going to be back with a vengeance. We're going to be bringing our big crew and all our dancers. And we are longing to see you all and hoping everybody is taking care of themselves and heeding the doctor's warnings and wearing their masks and be safe so we can all meet again next year. So on behalf of Nulla Casey on fiddle, Kathleen Boyle playing piano and harmony vocals, Mirella Murray on the accordion, Kate Purcell will be singing with you and playing guitar, Mary Coogan with me 35 years now as we celebrate 35 years of Cherish the Ladies. We were certainly looking forward to sharing this milestone with all of you, but we're going to press pause this year and celebrate in 2021. And I'm Joni Madden. I again play flute and whistles and harmony vocals. But we're going to finish up with a lovely old set of tunes called The Old Maids of Galway. And we have some fantastic dancers rounding up. And they've all shared the stage at Milwaukee with us at one time or another. So, folks, take care of yourselves. Looking forward to seeing Barry Stapleton and all his hardworking crew next year. And continue to support the Milwaukee Irish Fest, the best festival in the world. Take care, folks.
One called The Old Maids of Galway, and don't be looking at me like that. One, two, three, up.